Hello, everyone. Welcome to Harp, Hymns, and Hope. It's been a year since we did the first online concert under the same name. The past year has been fraught with challenges for us, but it also has been filled with growth, breakthroughs, and a better sense of our purpose on this earth. Tonight, we will see some very talented young and young-at-heart artists from different walks of life perform their passions. Also, this marks the first time we are showing an online concert in our website. Speaking of website, ours has a new design, hot off the press. Please do check it out and take it for a spin after the concert. We also launched an online store where you can buy originally designed harp t-shirts. Check out the store button above. If you scroll down this page, you will find other videos that we've produced in the past, along with some write-ups that we've made about the harp. Exploring on other pages of the site, you'll find information if you want to learn how to play the harp, together with the many lever and pedal harp models we distribute in the Philippines for Kamak Harps France. So please be sure to check those magnificent instruments out. Also, for about a year now, we've been doing Project Joyride, an initiative that we started where we distribute food packs and groceries to people on the street. As you may have noticed, the problems that beset our society last year are still the same problems that we have this year. A lot of people still do not have regular food on their table. So, if you want to help out, the donate button is right below this video. We hope you'll all have a great time watching this concert as much as we had a splendid time producing each video. Most importantly, we pray that we would be able to give you hope, joy, and encouragement this night. God bless you and enjoy the show. Thank you.
Thank you. Hi there, my name is Hans.
And I am Joanne.
We're a couple based in Quezon City. A few years ago, we were given a coffee plant by one of our good friends in the coffee industry. We named it Groot and placed it in a pot in front of Hillcrest Cafe, a coffee shop we managed in Sikatuna Village.
The cafe staff would water and take care of Groot, who was steadily growing day by day. When the pandemic hit the Philippines and lockdown was imposed in March 15, 2020, we were too busy and were caught by surprise.
We had to buy a week's worth of groceries 2 hours before all the stores closed. Initially, we thought that the lockdown would only be for a few days, but the days turned into weeks and the weeks turned into months with no signs of reopening. We then realized that the plants at the cafe haven't been watered for a long time.
When we checked, some of the plants were drying up but were still alive. But Groot lost all its leaves and the branches dried up. I felt so sorry for these plants and wanted to make it up to them. So every morning, I resolved to go to the cafe just to water the plants. I made it a habit to talk to the plants while watering them.
Which I think is both odd and cute. After about 2 weeks of watering, the other plants were coming back to life, but Groot showed no signs of springing back up. We then came to the conclusion that sadly, despite our best efforts, Groot was gone. We were quite sad, but a few days later, I noticed leaves starting to sprout.
He excitedly went home and told me, "Buhay si Groot! Groot is alive!" Just when I gave up, sure that Groot was no more, was when new life started to appear.
More than a year has passed. A lot of things have changed. The world and our lives are unrecognizable. Unfortunately, we had to close the cafe. In our family and circle of friends, we have lost a lot. An aunt and uncle and several good friends and one of our staff also passed away last September.
In these times of darkness, where do we turn for help, for comfort, and for hope? In Matthew 11, verse 28 to 30, Jesus is inviting us, saying, "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest."
Jesus doesn't promise us a life without problems and suffering, but assures us of his presence, as he said in John 16, verse 33. "I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world."
The Lord will not take us to where his grace cannot sustain us. So however difficult our circumstances, let our trust in our faithful God shine brighter.
Groot has steadily grown the past year. Pretty soon, we would need to transfer it to a bigger, more permanent place. Despite losing its leaves and a few branches, it has fought for life and is now thriving. It looks very different from what it was before, like it is also coping with a new normal. So if your life has changed this past year, don't give up. The one thing constant in life is change. Groot's story reminds us never to give up, never to back down, and to fight for whatever we have now, regardless of what we have lost, so we can live and let our life be a blessing to the lives that God has surrounded us with. I won't be surprised if one day we will get to drink a cup of delicious coffee from Groot. But whether or not that day comes, we shall hope in the Lord and in the strength of his might. The future is uncertain, but we are certain who holds the future, and that is enough.
My worth is not in what I own, not in the strength of flesh and bone, but in the costly wounds of love at the cross.
My worth is not in skill or name, in win or lose, in pride or shame, but in the blood of Christ that flowed at the cross.
I rejoice in my Redeemer, greatest treasure, wellspring of my soul. I will trust in him no other. My soul is satisfied in him alone.
As summer flowers we fade and die, fame, youth, and beauty hurry by, but life eternal calls to us at the cross. I will not boast in wealth or might, or human wisdom's fleeting light, but I will boast in knowing Christ at the cross.
Redeemer, greatest treasure, wellspring of my soul.